Hello everyone. In the previous class, we have studied the types of relation and example problems on that, right? In this class, we are going to solve some exercise problem. The first problem is determine whether the following relations are reflexive, symmetric, and transitive. We have to see here the given relations are reflexive, symmetric, and transitive or not. Okay. The given relation are in the set A. The set A, the given 1, 2, 3 up to 14 numbers, okay, defined as R is equal to relation what they given, set of all x comma y such that 3x minus y is equal to 0. Okay, now we have to check for reflexive, symmetric, and transitive. The first one is reflexive. Before going to write the reflexive, we have to write the relation, right? Then R is equal to, if I put the value of x is 1, see here, x is 1, that's then value of y is what? 3x, right? 3x minus y is equal to 0. Then y is equal to, you will get 3x. If I put the value of x is 1, then the value of y is 3 into 1 is 3. Then the value of x is 2. Then the value of y is 3 into 2, that is 6. In the same way, the value of x is 3, then the value of y is 3 into 3, 9. Then the value of x is 4, the value of y is 3 into 4, 12. And see here, I will stop here only, right? If the value of x is 5, then the value of y is 5 into 3, 15. But 15 is not in the given set. So this is our relation. Now we have to check one by one. Okay, the first one is reflexive. Reflexive. For reflexive, the condition is a comma a belongs to R, right? What we have to check here, the set of all, here in set A, all the elements of set A should have double pairs, right? All the elements of A have double pairs, then we call it as what? Reflexive. But here, no ordered pair is there, like 1, 1, 2, 2, 3, 3, up to 14, right? So 1 comma 1 does not belong to R here. 1 comma 1 does not belong to this relation. So, A comma A does not belong to R. Therefore, R is not reflexive. Not reflexive. Next, we are going to check for symmetric. Symmetric. For symmetric, if AB belongs to R, then BA also should belong to the relation, right? Then, if AB belongs to R, see here, 1, 3 belongs to this relation, but is there any 3, 1 belongs to 1? No, so 1, comma 3 belongs to R, but 3, comma 1 does not belong to R. Therefore, BA does not belong to R, right? Therefore, R is not symmetric. Not symmetric. The last one condition is transitive. For transitive, the condition should be if AB belongs to R and BA belongs to BC. So, right, AB belongs to R, then BC belongs to R, then what? AC must also belong to R, right? I will take AB, suppose 1 comma 3 belongs to R, then next, what happens? The second element should be the next first element, right? Here is there, 1 comma 3, 3 comma 9 is there, but 1 comma 9 is not in this relation. So, 1 comma 3 belongs to R, and BC means 3 comma 9 belongs to R. 3 comma 9 belongs to R, but 1 comma 9 is not in this relation, so 1 comma 9 does not belong to R. Therefore, A comma C does not belong to R. Therefore, R is not transitive. Therefore, R is not transitive. Next problem, problem is relation R in the set A, the given 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 elements in set A. As relation R is equal to set of all x, y such that y is divisible of x. We have to take such a relation here. Y is divisible of x. Okay. First we write the relation. Of course, the order base. 1 is divisible by 1. In the same way, 2 is divisible by 2. Up to 6 we are going to write. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and next is 1, 2 I will take, because 2 is divisible by 1, right? In the same way, 1, 3, 1, 4, 1, 5, and 1, 6. Next is see here, 2, 4 and 2, 6 we are taking. 2, 4, 2, 6. The last pair is 3, 6. 6 is divisible by 3 here. So, 3, 6. This is our relation. Okay. Now we will check for reflexive, symmetric, and transitive. The first condition is reflexive. For reflexive, the condition is all the elements of set A should have double base, right? Here you see all the elements of A up to 1 to 6 have double base, right? It is 1, 1, 2, 2, 3, 3, 4, 4, 5, 5, 6, 6. So this is reflexive. 1, 1, 2 up to 6, 6 is there, who belongs to this relation. So here x, belongs to R, right? Therefore R is reflexive. R is reflexive. Next we check for symmetric. For symmetric condition is if x, y belongs to R means then y, x also should belong to R, right? Before that I will write x, y belongs to R means see here. Suppose I will take 1, 2, okay? This 1, 2. But is there any 2, 1? It's reverse. Order pair. No, 2, 1 is not in the given relation. So 1, 2 belongs to R, but 2, 1 does not belong to R. But 2, 1 does not belong to this relation. Therefore, y, x does not belong to R. Therefore, R is not symmetric here. Does not belong to R, right? So R is not symmetric. Next we have to check it for transitive, right? For transitive, condition for transitive, if xy belongs to R, yx, yz belongs to R, then xz should also belong to R, right? So if x, y belongs to R, and y, z belongs to R, right? Then what? X, z should also belong to R. If I take, oh, which number? Okay, I will take 1, 3, okay? If 1, 3 belongs to R, then starts from 3. 3, 6 belongs to R, then 1 and 6 should also belong to this relation, right? Then 1, 6 is also belongs to this relation. So this is what? Transitive. X, y means I will take 1, 3 belongs to R, and for y, z 3, 6 belongs to R. Then what? 1, 6 should also be belongs to this relation. So 1, 6 belongs to R. This x, z belongs to R. Therefore R is transitive. R is transitive. Okay, next problem. Show that the relation R in the set R of real numbers. Here R is real numbers, right? Defined as R is equal to set of all A, B such that A is less than or equal to B square here. Okay. In Here we have to take such numbers. The Cartesian should be not reflexive, right? So I am taking 1/2 here. Fractions, okay. In real numbers you have to take, okay. 1/2 is less than or equal to 1/2 whole square. Then what you will get? 1/2 is less than or equal to 1/4. 2 square is 4, right? But here 1/2 is not less than or equal to 1/4, right? Here 1/4 is less than 1/2. So 1/2 is not equal to 1/4. Therefore, R is not reflexive here. Not reflexive. Okay, here what happens? A comma A does not belong to R. Right? The next is symmetry. Next is symmetry. For symmetry, A is less than or equal to B square. I will take some two numbers for A and B. Okay. If I put the value for A is 1 and for B here 1, 5. Right. Then what it happens? 1 is less than or equal to 5. Right here. 5 square means I will get 25. Of course, 1 is less than or equal to 25 here. Therefore, AB belongs to R. Okay. Then next here, then AB belongs to R means BA should also belong to R, right? So here I will take if B is less than or equal to what? A square here. Second condition, right? For that I will take same numbers, okay? Then how much you will get? 5 is less than or equal to 1. But here 5 is not less than or equal to 1. Therefore, B comma A does not belong to R. R is not trans-symmetric. Therefore, R is not symmetric here. R is not symmetric. The last is transitive. Transitive. For transitive, if A is less than or equal to B square and B less than or equal to C square, right? I will take for A 6 comma 3, okay? That is 6 is less than or equal to 3 square means 9. Suppose 6 is less than or equal to 9. That is what? AB belongs to R. And here I will take 3 comma 2, okay? Then the value of B is 3 and the value of C is 2 square, that is 4. Then 3 is less than or equal to 4, right? Therefore, BC should belong also belongs to R here, okay? Then what you have to check lastly? AC should also be belongs to R. Then 6, 2 I will take 6. 2 for A is less than or equal to C square, right? A is less than or equal to C square. For that, 6 is less than or equal to 4. No, so 6 is not less than or equal to 4. Therefore, A comma C does not belong to R. Therefore, R is not transitive. Therefore, R is not transitive. Okay, next problem. Check whether the relation R in the set 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 as R is equal to relation set up on A comma B such that B is equal to A plus 1 here, okay, is reflexive, symmetric and transitive. We have to check here the given relation is reflexive, symmetric and transitive or not, okay. This set given, right? We have to write the relation first. The value of A is 1. The value of A is 1 means the value of B is 1 plus 1, that is 2. If the value of A is 2, the value of B is your 3. If the value of A is 3, then the value of B is 3 plus 1, 4. If the value of A is 4, then the value of B is 4 plus 1, 5. If the value of A is 5, the value of B is 6. If the value of A is 6 means the value of B is 7, but 7 is not in the given set. relation. Okay. Now we find one. Check one by one. Okay. Reflexive. First one is reflexive. For reflexive, all the elements of set A should have double pairs. But in relation, no double pairs is there. So 1, 1 does not belongs to R. Therefore, A, does not belongs to R. Therefore, R is not reflexive. R is not reflexive. Okay. The next one is symmetric. For symmetric, if AB belongs to R, then BA should also belong to R. If suppose 1, 2 is there, but 2, 1 is not in this set, right? So if AB belongs to R, that is 1, 2 belongs to R, right? But 2, 1 does not belongs to R. That is BA does not belongs to R. Then R is not. Therefore, R is not symmetric. R is not symmetric. The last is transitive. For transitive, if AB belongs to R, 1, 2 is there, then BC, 2, 3 is also there, but 1, 3 is not in this relation, right? So AB belongs to R and BC belongs to R, right? For AB I will take 1, 2 belongs to R and 2, 3 belongs to R. But AC, 1, 3 is not in this relation, right? 1, 3 does not belongs to R. That is A, C does not belongs to R. Therefore, R is not transitive. R is not transitive. Okay, next problem. Show that the relation R in the set A, 1, 2, 3. In set A, the elements are 1, 2, 3 given by R is equal to 1, 2, 2, 1. Already they given the relation. Okay. It's symmetric but neither reflexive nor transitive. Already they given the relation, but we have to check here. Is we have to show that. Okay. They given relation. We have to show that the relation is symmetric but neither reflexive nor transitive. Okay. I will write relation R is equal to what they given, 1, 2 and 2, 1. Right. Now for reflexive, the condition is what? A, A belongs to R, right? But all the elements of A here, no double pairs is there, right? So 1, 1 does not belongs to R here. Therefore A, A does not belongs to R, right? Therefore R is not reflexive. Is not reflexive. Not reflexive. Second one is symmetric. For symmetric, the condition is AB belongs to R. See, 1, 2 is there. 2, 1 is also there, right? So 1, 2 belongs to R. 2, 1 also belongs to R. This would be A. So belongs to R. R is, therefore R is symmetric. R is symmetric. R is symmetric. We have to. Okay. The next R, we have to show that transitive. We have to show that R is not transitive here, right? Not transitive. If AB belongs to R and BC belongs to R. If I take 1, 2, then 2, 1 is also there, right? 1, 2 belongs to R and 2, 1 also belongs to R. But if here 1, 1 is not in this R, C does not belong to R. Therefore, R is what? Not transitive. R is not transitive. R is not transitive. So, students, in this class, we have solved some exercise problem, right? In the next class also, we are going to solve some more problems, okay? Thank you.